Let us now study about the maximum deviation of light by a prism. This variation curve of deviation angle with incidence angle we already studied. Here we can see that there are two situations under which the deviation angle is maximum. Now let us analyze what are these two situations. Here we can write there are two conditions under which a deviation is maximum. Here, if we just analyze the two situations for a prism, here we can see if this is a prism, then we already studied in situation 1, light ray passes through the prism symmetrically, the deviation angle is minimum. So obviously, if the angle of deviation is increased, angle of incidence is increased beyond that particular symmetry path, the value of deviation angle will increase. And the maximum angle at which the light can incident onto it is the grazing incidence, that is when I is equals to 90 degree. Now, in this situation, light will enter into the prism at an angle, critical angle theta c. And on the other side, the angle will be a minus theta c. And light will come out at some emerging angle E. Now in this situation we can see this is the original direction of incident light and this is the direction in which light is finally emerging out. So this is the value of deviation angle which will be maximum. Because beyond 90 degree there can never be any light which can incident on a surface. So this is a situation so where delta is maximum. So here we can see the angle of incidence when it becomes 90 degree, the value of deviation angle is maximum. So here we can write the maximum value of incidence angle should be 90 degree when the value of delta is maximum. Similarly, there should be an angle which is below I naught or the angle of incidence corresponding to minimum deviation. There should be an angle I1 at which again the value should be same. Here we can see this value E must be equals to I1. As according to law of retraceability of light, if a light incident onto a matte surface at an angle I1, on the other surface, it will incident at an angle critical angle theta c and it will finally graze along the other matte surface and the deviation angle will remain same. So here we can see if the situation is drawn with the reversibility of light, that of a light incident onto an angle I1, such that on the other surface it incident at an angle theta c. For this it must be a minus theta c. And finally the light ray will be grazing out or emerging ray will be grazing along the matte surface and here E will be equals to 90 degree. So, the two situations are mirror images of each other and here we can see this was the original direction of light and this is the value of delta max which will remain same in both the situations. Here you can see in this realistic situation when a light ray is incident onto the prism such that the incidence angle and emerging angle are equal. Here you can see the deviation angle is minimum. Now, if the incident angle is increased, incidence angle is increased, you can see when it reaches 90 degree or incident ray is grazing along the matte surface, the deviation angle is maximum and reaching up to the value of delta max. And if further this angle of incidence is decreased, again when it becomes I naught, the deviation is minimum and if I is decreased below I naught, again, the value of deviation angle starts increasing and when the light ray is grazing along the other matte surface or when angle of emergence is 90 degree here, you can see again the deviation angle will be maximum. So, there are two situations. One is of grazing incidence. One, we can see that deviation angle is maximum and other is the situation of grazing emergence. One, the angle of deviation is maximum. So, these are the two situations corresponding to maximum deviation of a light passing through the prism.